Hi everyone, and welcome to another Google Developers Live, where today we have a pretty cool announcement for the Google Drive SDK. That is the addition of a new part of the API for managing comments and replies. So actually a feature a lot of people have been asking for a long time, even before Google Drive was called Google Drive, and we had a Google Docs list and the various editors. And there's a lot of people that love Google Docs and spreadsheets and presentations. And the commenting and reply features in there are really great. But if you're a developer and you're trying to build workflow applications around docs and editing and workflow, they've just been inaccessible in the past. Starting today, these are now available. We'll actually go into show some examples of how to use the API. And those of you who have been keeping an eye on our library and our documentation and the client libraries and getting updates, you've probably actually seen these in the APIs already. They've actually been there for a couple of weeks, but we're just today making it official. So I just want to switch over and just have a doc up here, just full of some randomly generated lorem ipsum text, and a couple of comments. Really, if you use Google Docs, this should be really familiar to most people. But there's a couple things I want to point out that we have. We have comments and we have replies. So you can see this second comment here. This has a reply. And of course, we can do things like edit and delete and resolve, add new replies. All that functionality that you get inside of our editors is now available via the API. And the really cool part about this is you can actually manage comments and replies for any file. It's not just ours, but if you're building your own editor and you have your own doc format, you're certainly, and those files are in Google Drive, you can actually build your own UI for managing comments, take advantage of our API for the storage and notifications that come along with that, and just make it behave very similar to the editors that people are already used to working with. So to see actually how this works from an API perspective, I'm going to switch over to our APIs Explorer. And this is, I should take a step back here. We have all our APIs. This is a great tool for those who aren't familiar with it. If you are trying to learn some of our APIs, the APIs Explorer is just really awesome. It gives you all of our new APIs. You can click in, drill onto them, see all the different methods. And the ones that I want to focus on today, of course, are the drive.comments collection, and we have, of course, a corresponding drive.replies. And really, the main differences is comments and replies are very similar, actually. Just the difference is comments are attached to documents, and replies are, of course, attached to comments. So it's just basically a nested collection. Let's go into our drive.comments.list method here. Great tool. Again, tells you what you need. Really, all we need to list comments is a file ID. So I'm going to go back here and I'm just going to snag this out of the URL. And we'll execute this. So also, if you're using this tool and it gives you an error, there is this little button up here for authorizing access to Drive. I already did this a little while ago. My credentials are still valid. But let's actually take a look at what the response was. And we can see here we get back a comment list collection. And we can see it's a collection of comments. In this case, we have two. We have the two top-level comments that one is this is little trivia bit about one of the words that appeared in there, and another one just about my poor use of an example doc using generic lorem ipsum text. And then within there, we actually have we actually have a replies collection. So basically, everything that we need in order to render a UI for what is a comment activity on a document, we could actually just get in a single call. In addition to getting the actual content of the comments, we actually get a lot of information about who the author was. We get a display name. We get a link to their profile URL. In this case, this particular account doesn't have a profile set up, so we're just getting kind of the generic person icon. But if this were somebody who was using Google Plus and they had a proper profile, you'd actually be able to show an image of that person along with their name so that you can have a very nice social experience with displaying those comments. The The other really important bit here is this anchor. And I'm going to talk a little bit more about this in a few minutes. But this basically tells us where in the document this comment applies to. In this case, because this is our format, we do have a proprietary anchoring scheme, which does make it difficult for, or actually rather impossible for you to create comments that are anchored to text in our document formats. But if it's a document format that you control, or if it's something where you know, there's ways to locate it in a kind of an interchangeable way. And again, I'll talk about this in a little bit more detail later. You can put anchors in there that, you know, your app can position correctly and potentially that other apps could read and position correctly as well. So basically we have content, we have an author, we have content, we have the location. And then of course we have the replies, which again, very similar author information for who made the reply along with the content. And of course, we have the standard stuff that we see in most of our collections, whether or not this is a deleted comment or a reply. The status for comments is actually pretty important for marking things as open comments that still need action versus resolved, indicating that the people on the thread have agreed that whatever the comment was, that issue is now addressed. So pretty basic. So let's actually try creating a comment. So I mentioned earlier that it's not possible right now to insert an anchored comment into our documents. That said, you can actually insert an unanchored comment into a Google Doc. So I'm going to say this is a comment. We'll execute that. And it's successful. We can see it. It knows my author information, creates it. You could also put HTML content in there. Right now, I'm just putting plain text. But if you want to put HTML instead of plain text, you can do that as well. And we could render comments and with some tags. If it's bold or italicized or strikeouts and so on. Now I could actually go up here and we see in our full comments list we have this unanchored comment, which we can either comment on, resolve, or do whatever we need to do. We can delete. If you want to do a reply to a comment, it's actually not all that difficult. Let's go back and list our comments again. Put in our file ID. And I'm going to reply back to, how about this thread here? This is a, we do need our comment ID in order to do this. So actually I have another tab open. This is the replies insert method. And I already copied earlier while put in the file ID just to make life a little easier. And I'm going to put in the comment ID as well. And let's say, we'll just put in something a little silly and execute. Oops, and I did not authenticate recently enough on here. I'll just reauthorize. And here we go. So now we were able to insert a reply for that comment. If we go back in here, this actually updated and we can see that new reply. So that's really the nature of the comments replies. You have comments, you have replies. You can do all the normal operations that you would do in working with a list of files, you can do with comments. So for example, by default, deleted comments are removed from the collection. When you query for comments, you could ask for include deleted. You can combine that with updated min timestamps if you want to, for example, pull for changes and find which comments since the last time you pulled have been added, which ones have been deleted. If a comment is deleted, we do return tombstone entries as you would expect and as we do for most of our APIs. And that's really it. So I want to switch over to, I've been mentioning anchors for a while. And so I want to talk about them. So really what I want to point out is if you go to our documentation page here, we do have this new page here, /drive/manage comments. And if you read through here, there's actually a fairly lengthy section here on talking about anchoring comments and different schemes here for interoperable formats for anchoring content to documents. So for example, if you have text, then you know there's a couple different schemes that you might want to do. You might want to anchor a comment to a page. You may want to do it to a range of text. This is basically using offsets and how many characters are in the range, a line in a file. Likewise, if you're doing things like video or audio, you might want to be able to anchor comments to a point in time in that audio or video clip, and of course give it, you know, a range for how long that how long of that segment the comment applies to. There's also different formats for, you know, regions in an image. So if you're commenting on a mock-up for you know, a new product, and you want to be able to do things in an image, you can do lines, you can do, you know, rectangles or points, and you can come up with your own schemes as well. We do recommend that if you are doing your own scheme, that you prefix it with your application ID. And even if you go back over to here, you can see this anchor scheme here for our own, where's the anchor here? The anchor here, so this Kix is basically our internal app ID for the document editor. And this is just a custom marker that is meaningful to us, but not to really anyone else. So if you, you know, if you have, for example, an XML document, you know, a pretty good anchoring scheme would be something like an XML element ID. Likewise, if it's a format that you can control and you have markers that are meaningful anchors for a comment, you can, you know, any way that you can identify those, feel free to use those as an anchor yourself. One of the challenges with anchors, however, is currently in the version of the API that just launched, the anchors are immutable on a comment. So this has imposes certain limitations. For example, an anchor which is based off of a line in a text file, given that's immutable, that anchor is only relevant to a specific revision of a file. So you do need to make sure that if you are anchoring comments to a file based on some sort of relative position, offset to the file, where, you know, if the content changes, that might invalidate the anchor, that you only use anchored comments on read-only files. So for example, you're sending out something for review, you might want to, make sure that the people who are commenting on it can't modify the file, that it's going to be, you know, static for at least some period of time. The anchoring scheme does actually have a field for the revision ID, so that you do know that if the content has changed, that you may have to invalidate those comments, as the positions may no longer be relevant. It is something that we do plan on changing to make sure that anchors can be changed, so that if you do need to reposition them as the file changes and those positions change, that you'll be able to do that. But for now, basically the recommendation is either use anchored comments on read-only files, if you're using one of these kind of, you know, positioned anchors where it's sensitive to the format of the document. The second option would be to use a custom scheme. This would be something, again, if you have a format that you can control and you can embed the anchors, or you have some natural structures like XML element IDs, then just use a custom scheme that you can manage. And then if the structure of the content changes, the structure of the file changes rather, and those anchors were to be deleted, you would have at least some way to detect whether or not a comment was still valid or not. And then, of course, the third option is just to forego using anchors. Then you could just use document level comments, which are still really valuable for a lot of content. You just have to kind of, you know, figure out depending on what type of file you're doing. But again, for most, a lot of the formats that we're seeing people do, they are proprietary formats. They have a lot more flexibility for embedding anchors. And in those cases, the API is actually really easy to use and very powerful. Trying to think if there's anything else that is really worth noting. Oh, permissions are actually pretty important. So one of the things, a couple people had asked about early on when we launched the Drive API was in our permission list, we did have a commenter role. And of course, a lot of people wondered, why do you have a commenter role if there's no commenting functionality? Now you know there's actually a good reason for using that role. And it starts to make a lot more sense if you are building in commenting functionality into your app to start to honor that role, whether or not somebody has either edit, owner edit, or commenting permissions. That then you would, enable the features for adding a comment. If they don't have any of those roles, then you want to make sure that you disable those features in your UI so that the user doesn't try to create a comment and then get an error when they actually try to save it. But again, those same practice that you should be doing anyway for a Drive application. Always making sure that you check ahead of time whether or not user has permission, not for security, but really for usability, just to make sure that the user doesn't go too far down any particular path when the end result is doomed to fail. But really, that is really about it for it. We do have a couple trusted testers who had been working on this. I do expect in the next few weeks that we will see a number of applications out there come out with integration with the Comments API. Some of them I think are going to be really cool. And once those start coming up in the Chrome Web Store or in other places, we'll try to point them out as an example for people. But other than that, have fun with the API. I'm really excited to see what people are going to do with this. And that's really about it. Come join us again next time. We do have some more features coming up pretty soon. I do believe we are off for next week. It is Thanksgiving. And even though we're normally here on early in the week, I think we're going to just take the whole week off. But after that, come back and we'll have some more announcements. We have some new quick starts that we've been working on. Actually, an iOS quick start just got posted yesterday. We'll do a session on that. Again, another couple more features. A little bit smaller than comments, but some really cool and useful stuff coming up as well. And other than that, thank you very much.